A popish carnival.
A masquerade.
For 1 week only, ere it be Lent. A wench's time is freely spent.
Join us in this celebration
of legal authorised fornication.
To stage this play is our task.
For those of you who wear a mask,
our carnival's about to start.
Is yours a true or roving heart?
This is a man's world. This is a man's world. But it would be nothing.
I would fain know as much as you. I know you're a lover. Tell me, who does you sigh for?
When you're a lover, I'll think you fit for a secret of that nature.
'Tis true, I never was a lover yet. But I begin to have a shrewd guess what 'tis to be so, and fancy a very pretty to sigh, and sing, and long, and wish, and blush, and wish to see the man, and when I do, the pale and tremble just as you did when our brother brought home that fine colonel from England to see you. What do you call him, Florinda? Belleville!
Helena!
Or is it Don Antonio, the viceroy's son? Or perhaps that rich old Don Vincentio who our father designs you for a husband?
Why do you blush?
Open invitation! Marry Don Vincentio? I shall let my father see. I understand what's better and due to my beauty, birth and fortune. And more to my soul. Marry Don Vincentio? Never. Now, hang me if I don't adore thee for that dear disobedience. I love mischief strangely, as most of our sex do.
But tell me, Florinda, don't you love that fine Belleville?
I must own, have I known not what pleased kindly for him about my heart, and will suffer no other to enter?
Helena, a maid designed for a nun ought not to be so curious in a discourse of love.
Dost thou think that ever I'll be a nun?
Yes!
Not till I am so old I am fit for nothing else. Tell me, what dost thou see about me that is so unfit for love? Have I not a world of youth? A humour gay, a beauty passable, a vigour desirable? Well-shaped, clean-limbed, sweet breath. And sense enough to know how all this ought to be pointed at best advantage. Yes, I do, and will.
Prithee, be not so wild.
And you, Sister Mouse, how goes your heart?
It hath a kind of carnival beating. And though I prattle not so much as you, sisters, my mind's as busy as both of you together. When our brother has gone out into finery, I have a device to unfold.
Madam, your brother comes.
My sisters. Florinda, when saw you your lover, Don Vincentio?
Never, for sure, I do not think of him.
It's our father's command that you ought not despise a man of so vast a fortune, such a passion for you. Callous, my things.
Passion for you? I hate Vincentio, sir. And I should not have a man so dear to me as my brother, one of the ill customs of his country, and make a slave of his sister. Oh, sweet Pedro, my father's will, I'm sure you may divert.
I know not how dear I am to you. I only wish to be ranked in your esteem equal, as you do my friend, Colonel Belleville. Why do you blush? Is there any guilt belonging to the name of that cavalier?
I'll not deny I value Belleville. Will you not allow him my esteem?
Yes, pay him what you will in honour, as I do. But you must consider Don Vincentio's fortune, and the jointer he'll make you.
Let him consider my youth, beauty, and fortune, which ought not to be thrown away on age and jointure.
Yes, pay what you will in honour, as I will. But you must consider Don Vincentio's fortune, and the jointer he'll make you.
Well, is that not better than any Don Vincentio has?
Yes. It is a confinement to be carried to the country, to a rich villa owned by the Vincentios.
And if these be her daily divertissements, what are those of the night? To lie in a wide, moth-eaten bedchamber, where the old giant encases his feeble carcass, stretches himself, sighs a belch or two, stales in his pot, farts loud as a musket, and throws himself into bed where he expects you in his foul sheets.
Have you done yet?
And this man you must kiss and muzzle through his beard to find his lips. And this you must submit to for 80 years and all for a fortune. Marry Don Vincentio. Hang me. Such a wedlock would be worse than adultery with another man.
Callus, take her hence and lock up all carnival. And at Lent, at the end of the week, she should begin her everlasting penance in a nunnery.
Shall I so? I am like to make a fine nun. I have an excellent tumour for a cloister.
Callus, make it your business to watch over this wildcat. Fie, you both a troublesome pair to me. I would you were both as modest as your sister Valeria is. But for you, Flamingo, true I urge my father's will. His mind is that you marry Antonio, the viceroy's son. He is brave and young, and all complete in the happiness of a gallant maid. With my father's absence, we will use this opportunity to free from Vincenzo by marrying here, which you will do tomorrow.
Tomorrow?
Tomorrow! Before my father returns, or it will be too late. It is not only my friendship to Antonio makes me urge this, but my love for thee. Therefore thou shalt stay in thy chamber and resolve upon tomorrow.
Yes, sir. I shall strive to do so and shall become your sister.
I both believe and trust you. Callus! Look to it. Adieu.
Hark you, Callus. You'll not be so cruel as to lock us up indeed, will you?
I must obey the commands I have.
Callus! I need to now perceive my room anear. I have no defence against Antonio's love. For he has all the advantages of nature, both fortune and power in this place.
You have a defence, Clorinda.
I've none. I'm ruined.
Fine. Marry Belleville within these 2 days. Neither our brother nor our father can compel you to another.
Nay, she shall not.
But how? I'm pent up and have no access to him. You shall have, if I may rule you. If we would have man, me must win man, and be a little wanton, Evie one.
Oh, I dare not.
No, it's a pity. Nay, listen. I am guised in this chest, should serve for all of us to go together. Yes, and you likewise.
Me? Oh, we dare not be so free.
Why think you there be carnivals, but that men and women may be free as they will ere Lent become?
You may not go.
Helena, here's stuff for you. If Belleville sees me in a guise, he'll think me too free. Why think you there... Must I expound to you the very pith of carnival? Why you think our brother Pedro has gone thither?
To lie with wenches.
No. And why in so fantastic and lusty a guise? To maintain his sober reputation to the world. Have I not heard thee say women should do as men do?
Faith, I have an itch of going. If I thought your brother might not know it, and I might wait on you.
Then put this and this on.
What in gear is this?
We shall go as gypsies.
What's my bashful and then all to say?
Fine, be that which I know you inly are. If wenches need be demure and nice year in and out, 'tis fit they should be free and frolic for 1 week in the calendar. It begins!
Now I have a rare itch to dance into your fellow.
Then let's vie with one another who shall first win her man.
Oh, I'll write a note. Here we go. Oh, what a chance to Belleville. Although he'll not know it is me, I'll let him know that Florinda favours him.
Oh, yes, I'll give him all the letters I have written.
I dare not send in fear of my brother.
Haste, haste!
Now, Senyago, does a patron of carnival smile on our devising?
Well, then be none.
Though I be shamed or shent, I'll try my fortune here and be left.
Oh, Colonel! The devil ails you, Colonel. In a time when all the world is gay to look so melancholy.
I cannot divine the cause. Unless it's the old cause, the wants of Mally.
Or your old cause, the wants of a wench.
And ask it, would not that revive you?
You are mistaken, Ned.
Oh, I have it. It is Florinda.
Florinda, thou hast brought us here to pursue thy acquaintance with the lady Poxon. And what do you call her? Florinda! Well, my conscience, thou lovest in spite, too, because thou seest little or no possibility of gaining her.
Thou art mistaken, Fred.
I have interest enough in that lovely virgin's heart to make me proud and vain. Were it not abated by the severity of her brother, Pedro, who perceiving my happiness...
I severely forbid me the house.
Tis so, to make way for a powerful rival, Don Antonio, Viceroyster, who has the advantage of me of being a man of fortune, a noble Spaniard, and her brother's friend, which gives him liberty to make his court, whilst I only have recourse to letters and distant looks from her window.
Oh, I dare swear. I've had 100 as young, kind, and handsome as this Florinda. And dogs eat me, if they were not as troublesome to me morning as they were welcoming to me night.
And yet I warrant you would not touch another woman, lest you might have her for nothing.
Colonel? Wilmore? Dear Belville! Noble Colonel!
Welcome ashore, dear Rover! What happy wind blows this good fortune?
Let me salute my dear Fred and then command me. How is Thomas, lad?
Oh, babe, sir, no compliment. Infinitely the better to see my dear mad Wilmore again. Prithee, what bringest thou ashore?
My business, ashore, is only to enjoy myself a little at this carnival!
Hey!
I must aboard again in a day or two.
Pray, not our friend, sir. He's a raw traveller, but honest, stout, and one of us.
Your servant, sir. I'm a country gentleman from Essex.
Well, faith, I'm glad to meet you in a warm clime, where the kind sun has a godlike power still over the wine and the women. Love and mirth are my business here.
Well, now for some plump girl, with flat noses for convenience of kissing, with some brave, swelled lips, soft and sweet.
See, sir? Are these those kind merchants of love you look for?
Then ask you, what have we here?
Now the game begins, how they...
I'm pretty creatures. And what's here? May a stranger have leave to look and love. Roses for every month.
Roses for every month? What means that?
They are, or wouldn't you believe, they're courtesans. We're here to be hired by the month,
kind and obliging to inform.
You must take care, lest you be gulled.
Beware some roses, sir.
Oh. Hey, death, will you not be kind? Quickly be kind! By no means, use no violence here in carnival time.
Death! Just as I was going to be so damnedly in love to have her let off.
Let's find some other game.
Yes! But first, you must disguise and muzzle yourself as we have.
Why?
Because whatever extravagances we make in Masker's face, our own may not be obliged to answer them.
Nay, I will not change my eternal book.
Nay, you must prank yourself up a little like the rest, for 'tis carnival. These be good game.
The strangers too, I know it by their gazing. They're English too. And they, sir, they're a good-natured, loving people with generally so high an opinion of themselves that a woman with any wit may flatter them into any sort of fool she pleases.
Have a care, Chetta. These be cavaliers. The devil's in them when they get abroad.
Sure, Sancho, they have money to be gulled of.
Mark yon bumpkin that roars the loudest. When did I mistake your game? Go to
it! Nay, Sancho!
Go! Or I'll beat them. Yet, Mark, you will promise much but pay him little.
Fie on your jealous humour. If I understand my trade, he's mine. Roses for every month?
Ooh. So she is mine. I have beauties that my glass at home did not discover.
So what? Is this Essex calf the first of us to raise a shoe?
I hope 'tis some common crafty sinner that will sell him for slave. The rogue sturdy and will work well in a mine.
Ah, pox upon him. He's our banker, and if he were to fail, we'll all go broke.
'Tis a lucky devil to light upon so kind a wench. Oh, for my arms full of lusty, kind women!
Sister, there's your colonel!
And with him two proper fellows!
Nay, have a care. The devils are those English when they go abroad.
Perhaps gypsies on my life.
To them!
Let's come and talk to them. I'll begin.
There's a lively wench. Would I could drop an anchor in her cove.
Yonder in Buff's a proper fellow. I'll to him, and instead of telling his fortune, I'll try my own.
Dear, pretty, and I hope young devil, will you tell an amorous stranger what luck he's like to have?
Have a care how you venture with me, sir, lest I pick your pockets.
Egad,
I have so little money I dare not offer it thee for a kindness. But cannot you divine from me what other thing I have about me that I would more willingly part with?
Indeed, no. That is the business of a witch. I am but a gypsy yet. Yet without looking in your hand, I have a parlous guess. 'Tis some foolish heart you mean. An inconstant English heart as little worth stealing as your purse.
Ella, can this watch me so? I'll dare to discover myself.
Yes, I'll say. Sir,
by this line, you should be a lover.
Pray let me go on weary of falling.
But what, sir? And you have confessed that the passion that you avowed for Florinda be true or false.
Florinda?
Softly.
Thou hast named one that will fix me here forever.
Should we be disappointed then? Expect you this night to her garden gate if you fail.
Madam, away your brother forever.
Stay! And complete that joy which as it is will turn into distraction. Where must I be? At the garden gate, at night, you say?
Oh, take this to instruct you further.
I see, sir. You mean to ruin me. And so you shall, if once you catch me.
No. Thus, if I go with them again, for the very shame, no fellow takes me also. And yet, I see women may do most their business on earth alone, if they were to leave their city and try. And then, if I did not fear my master's anger, I might essay, and get some spicy fellow if I once spied one. Oh, fie! Is this she that is to be a nun?
I have come from the sea and have a world of love in store. Would you be good natured and take some of it off of my hands?
Well, I could be inclined that way. You have horrible loving eyes.
Let it be anything but a long siege and I'll undertake it.
Can you storm?
Most furiously.
Meet me in this place after dinner.
Yes, and what then?
And if you will, swear to keep your heart and not bestow it between this.
Oh, by all the little gods of love, I swear it. I'll leave it with you.
Then it is possible that I may see you.
Away, away, sister, our brother comes.
Oh, with your masks. All's well, our men are hurt.
Get into the field,
I warn you, we've come home.
Thou hadst a great deal of talk with thy little sister. Besides, you're no good upon her, mine was hard-hearted.
My young wench was so free and witty. She has played with my heart so that twill never lie still till I've met some kind young wench to play the game out with.
Oh, friends, the welcomest of news, the softest of letters.
The reason of this mighty joy?
Tis Florinda's hand. She invites me to deliver her from the threatened violence of her brother.
At 10 at night, at the garden gate, of which, if I cannot get the key, I will contrive a way over the garden wall. Come attended with a friend or two. Kind heart, if we three cannot weave a string to let her down a garden wall, 'twere a pity the hangman wove one for us all.
Colonel, I've been an ass, a deluded fool, a very coxcomb from my birth till this moment, and heartily repent my little faith.
What the devil's the matter with thee, Ned?
Oh, such a miserable friend, such a girl!
Where?
I were. Oh, so fond, so amorous, and so toying, and so kind. Oh, how she looked and kissed.
Pray, try if she has not left the taste of her balmy kisses upon my lips.
Oh, how I laughed at the colonel when he signed his love. Now the little archer has revenged him. Well, I'm resolved to settle in Essex and plant here forever.
Dost know her name?
Her name? And ask ye know. What need I for name? She's young, kind, fair and brisk, even to ravishment.
And did his give her anything?
Give her? Why, she's a person of quality. Dost think such creatures are to be bought? And art skins. She gave me this bracelet in exchange for a diamond I used to wear. Ned Blunt's not everybody. She expects me again tonight.
Egad, that's well. We can all go.
No, gentlemen. Not a soul. And art skins, you're all fools. There are things about this Essex calf that she'll take with the ladies, above all your parting wits. This size and shape, gentlemen, are not to be despised. My waist too, tolerably long, with other inviting things that shall remain nameless.
Well, sir, for all your nameless inviting signs, I shall be very glad to understand your purse be secure. But it is our whole estate at present.
You just give her a diamond, say you?
A pot, Ned! 'Tis some common whore upon my life.
A whore?
Yes, with such fine clothes and so well attended. A whore!
Well, yes, sir. They're all whores.
Pox aunt, where do these fine whores live?
I'll advise thee. One lives right here.
The famous Castellana, Angelica Bianca. See there, the fair son of the inn where a man may lodge, if he's willing to pay her price.
Oh, how wondrous a beauty she is. 1,000 crowns a month! Oh, plague of this poverty, which I now would complain but when it hinders my approach to beauty.
Here at England, 1,000 crowns a month is a sum. Sure, 'tis a mistake. Hark, you, friend, won't she trust?
This is a trade, sir, that cannot be by credit.
See, there, Don Pedro, we're in this for them. Let's walk off a while.
Oh, how I long to see the shadow of that fair substance.
1,000 crowns a month. Fetch me 1,000 crowns. I will have this beauty.
What said those fellows to thee?
The first were admirers of beauty only, but no purchasers. They were merry with your price and picture, laughed at the sum, and then passed off.
No matter, I'm not displeased by their rallying.
The last I knew through all his disguises to be Don Pedro, nephew to your old lover, the Spanish general.
Don Pedro, my old gallant's nephew. When his uncle died, he left him a vast sum of money. Don Pedro.
It is he that used to prance before our window and take such care to show himself an amorous ass. If I'm not mistaken, he is the likeliest man to pay your price.
Nay, he's of a humour so uneasy and inconstant that the victory over his heart is as soon lost as won. But inconstancy is a sin of all mankind, therefore I am resolved that nothing but more gold shall ever charm my heart.
I'm glad on't. 'Tis only money women of our profession ought to consider. Though I wonder, what has kept you from this general disease of our sex so long? I mean that of being in love.
Kind but sullen star under which I had the happiness to be born. Nay, I've no time for love. I've been too busy winning admiration. I thank my star I've longed for no man yet. What need I, since all I see is offered before I ask? I've refused many, but never yet desired one.
Yet thou hast enjoyed many.
Yea, at a golden rate.
What need this carnival trick? You have youth and future to spare, and may look about and choose your men at leisure.
I'll not stay in this town 1 month longer, Moretta, but for the vanity and pleasure to see and be seen. While the old general lived, his jealousy kept me locked up to the world, never to be seen or enjoyed. But now the general's dead, I'll seek my pleasure and leave a name and memory behind me. I know few will like to pay the money, nor want I any neither. My pleasure is to see men gaze and sigh. And when the carnival's over, I'll be gone.
See, Don Pedro returns.
And there's Antonio, the viceroy's son.
Thousand crowns. Well, I heard of her beauty before, but it's a fire in my soul. This picture's blown into a flame.
Ha! I see a rival for my love.
Sir, I have known you throw away 1,000 crowns on a worse face. And though you are soon to be married, you may venture a little love here. Florinda will not know it.
Ha! Florinda? Sure, 'tis Antonio.
Florinda? Name not those distant joys. There's not one thought that would check my passion here. Fetch me 1,000 crowns. She is charming, fair.
'Tis he. The false Antonio. My sister scorned all my hopes of feet in the possession of Angelica. I will give her 1,000 crowns if his be fetched.
Friends, where must I pay my offering, my love? 'Tis my 1,000 crowns, I mean.
That offering, sir, I desire to make, and yours has come too late. Prithee be gone.
Who must this rival be? Sirrah, go hence, or I shall grow angry else, and then thou art not safe.
My anger may be fatal, sir, as Jules.
I not know who thou art. But thou will work my killing for aiming at Angelica.
That kid is fine. Tilt it for the wench, I'm sure.
Watch off! I take over time and place.
For this is designed for lovers.
We are prevented. By whom I know not. Dares meet me tomorrow morning on the molo.
For
For I'm a title to a better quarrel for that of Florinda, in whose credulous heart thou'st make an interest and destroy my hopes.
Dare, I'll meet thee as early as day.
We shall come thus disguised, but whoever chance the better may escape unknown.
It shall be so.
This posture's loose and negligent. The sight on't would beget a warm desire in souls with impotence and aged chill. Tis a must along with me.
What means this rudeness, sir? Restore the picture!
Ha! Rudeness committed to the fair Angelica! Restore the picture, sir.
Nay, I will not, sir.
By heavens, you shall.
Nay, show swords no more. For if you do, I swear by this dear beauty. I'll show mine too.
These be the English, all rogues and rovers.
Let's teach them, sir, what tis to fire flintlock during carnival.
Tis well, yet I'll meet with thee tomorrow. Sir, restore the picture, or leave your lies behind.
Death, you lie.
We will do neither. Heavenly fair she is. A plague of her price.
You, sir, in Buff, that first began this insolence.
'Tis true, I did so. I saw your charming picture and was wounded quite through my soul. And wanting 1,000 crowns to procure my remedy, I say to lay your little picture to my bosom. Which, if you cannot allow me, I'll resign.
Nay, take the trifle. Come into the house. I shall have words with you.
Gentlemen, your servant.
Ah, it's a devil indeed. Don't go to danger of entering a house of an incensed courtesan.
Oh, let me go.
Yes, to your lodging if you will, but not in there.
Death, man, shall murder thee.
Shall I not venture where a beauty calls?
She'll as soon stab thee as she will lie with thee. You shall not go.
Oh, let him, Colonel, come. We'll find a sounder whore for 6 pence in the galley that's just come in.
Then ask him. I believe the gentlewoman means well.
Well, take thy fortune, and expect you in the next street.
The rogue's stark mad for a wench.
Insolent devil, how durst you pull down my picture?
Rather, how durst you set it up? To tempt poor, amorous mortals with so much excellence. Is all this heaven of beauty shown to move despair in those who cannot afford to buy?
God
weather
be to sober, will you set sail? The price
too high
I'm of you, therefore tack off, I say.
Here, good forewoman of the shop, serve me and I'll be gone.
Keep it, to pay your laundress, your linen stinks to the gun room.
Thou hast in thy time sold plenty of thy stale ware at the cheap rate.
Aye, the more silly kind heart, aye, you know the price.
Granted, 'tis here set down, 1,000 crowns a month. Pray, how much may come to my share for a pistol?
The poor old fellow, we only sell by the whole piece.
'Tis hard. The whole cargo or nothing. Faith, madam, my stock will not reach it. I'm studying, madam, how to purchase you. Though at present, I'm unprovided of money.
Sure, just as many other man would anger me. Nor shall he know the conquest he has made. Poor and from bold man, how I despise this rallying.
Yes, I am poor and from bold. I'm a gentleman, one that scorns this baseness which you practice. Though poor, I would not sell myself to buy your person. Though I admire you strangely for your beauty, yet I condemn your mercenary mind.
Why dost say I'm mercenary? Sir, I thought you must be gone. How dare you take such freedom? Withdraw! Sure, she's bewitched and stands there frost tamely in only saucy railing.
Withdraw!
Why dost say I'm mercenary? You men are strangely partial to yourselves. Who made the laws by which you judge me? Men! And are men not as mercenary as I?
Oh, not I, as thou.
Nay. And when a woman is proposed to you to be your wife, you do not ask how fair or how virtuous she is. But what's her fortune, if but small? You cry, she will not serve, and basely leave her.
'Tis a barbarous custom. I scorn to defend it in our sex, as I despise it in yours.
Well said.
Then take my purse and me.
Nay, put up like gold. I will not sell thee kindness for the sake of kindness.
What's her meaning?
Thou shalt not buy, my love.
Why then, farewell.
Nay, stay a little. Couldst thou not give me love?
My faith, like anything.
Confirm that faith and I'll...
Do what?
I cannot tell. I dare not hear thee talk. Thou hast a charm in every word that draws my heart away. I've never loved before, thou water mistress. Yet thou hast undone me. Couldst thou not storm on still? I then perhaps would be as free and all as fiery.
Death, how she throws her flames about my soul.
What? Lingering still? Will you pay me the price I ask? Thy love for mine? Can you give me that?
Entirely.
Swear it then.
Why, so I do. Come, let's withdraw, or I'll renew my vows and breathe them with such ardour thou cannot doubt my zeal.
Thou hast a power too strong to be resisted. Is all our project fallen to this? To love such a shame room, nay, a beggar, a pirate beggar, whose business is to rifle and be gone. No purchase, no tattered medallion, an English picaroon, a rogue that fights for his daily drink. Oh, I could curse now if I durst. This is the fate of most whores. Trophies from which believing fops we win are those to whom cousin us again. Methinks we've learnt this trade of gypsies as readily as we've been bred upon the road to Loretto.
Thou bist so flaunt and ogle, and I thought you meant to lure all thy cities to thy bed.
Methinks Helena has been very serious ever since.
Hey ho, I am as sad as a lover's lute. Yet for all your laughing, I am not in love. Oh, and yet I can't get him out of my head. Would I could meet some true damn gypsy that I might know my fortune.
Know it? Why, there's nothing so easy. Thou will love this wandering Constance till thou finds thyself hanged around his neck, and then be as mad to get free again.
Yes, Valeria, we should watch her board his frigate and follow him over the ocean. He has not kept his word with me here, and I fear he's taken up elsewhere. That thought is not very pleasant to me.
Oh. See? Here come my lovers back. Let's plague them still.
Where's my Constance?
Let's set aside and relearn something.
Oh, what means this? The picture's taken in. Maybe the wench is good natured and will be kind gratis.
I'd rather think she has cut his throat and has fled. Come, let's shout and call for him.
My heart goes a pit about the fish as my man may talk of.
Wilmore!
What would you have?
Told a stranger who entered here about 2 hours ago that his friends stay here for him.
A curse upon him from Moretta. He's coming to you.
aye, tis he. Oh, how this vexes me.
Oh, dear rogue. Are we to raise up the altars or break down our windows, eh?
Does not fortune sit triumphant on my brow? Dost not see the little one-tongued god there, all gay and smiling? Do I not have an air about my face and eyes that distinguish me from a crowd of common lovers? Oh, such a bona roba! To sleep in her arms is lying in fresco, all perfumed air about me.
Here's fine encouragement for me to fool on.
Come, let's be gay in one time. Some wine! And gentlemen, see, here are the friends they will supply us. Hark, what a charming sound they make.
But, sir, you were not married, are you?
All the honey of matrimony with none of the steam.
Pox on, thou art a fortunate rogue.
The Dartskins have two of us provided for. Oh,
by the light, thou art fortunate, men. Oh, my little gypsy now.
Fortune smiles on us, gentlemen. Smiles on us.
Sir, my lady expects you. She has removed all that might oppress your will and pleasure, and is impatient until you come.
I shall attend you, sir. Oh, the happiest of rogues! Her husband has gone hence. I shall take no leave, lest they dog me or stay me.
Lol, how Ned's in a lure. I hope she'll dress him for our mirth, cheat him of all, then have him well favourably banged and cast out at midnight.
So, Captain, the little gypsy forgot?
A mischief on thee for putting her into my thoughts.
I quite forgot her else. And this night's debauch had quite drunk her down.
Had it so good, Captain!
I hope she did not hear me.
Gypsies, come, Colonel!
You're a fine lady of your word, are you not? To make a man languish a whole day.
In tedious search of me.
In that thou art in the wrong. If thou had seen what a melancholy dog I had been since I last saw you, heart, thou wouldest pity me.
Now if I should be hanged, I can't be angry with him, for him dissemble so heartily.
Come, let me see thy face.
Heavens, it is he. So passionately fond to see another woman.
See if this be a lying lover's look. How do you like it, Captain?
Like it? By heaven, I never saw so much beauty. The charms of those sprightly brown eyes, that strangely fair face full of smiles and dimples, those soft, round, melting cherry lips and small, even white teeth. Not to be expressed, but silently dumb. Oh, one more look and strike me dumb.
Oh. I can enjoy no more, for if I do, my jealousy will destroy my reason. Sebastian! And follow that woman and learn who it is.
Nay, stay, sir.
What shall I do next? Prithee, dear stranger, though you have not eaten your love for Florinda, you see my friend offers you hares to play with in the meantime.
Faith, madam, I shall not play her games.
Oh, believe me, noble stranger, I'm no common mistress, but little prince will wear this jewel. I take it, sir.
Madam, why am I chose out of all mankind to be the object of your bounty?
Sir, from my window I have often seen you. And a woman of my quality has so few opportunities of love that we ought to lose none.
Ah, here's a woman. Now when shall I be blessed with so much kindness from thy fair mouth?
When my sister cries...
Take the jewel, fool!
You tempt me strangely, madam, in every way. But I have made a vow to a very fair lady, and I will not dishonour her.
Oh, pox! Be kind. In pity to me, be kind. For I am to thrive, but as you treat her friend, Belleville.
Also, it's true, tis Florinda.
Tis well.
Let's have them.
Then tell me what you did in yonder house and our own month.
Yonder house?
Yonder house.
Oh, yonder house. Oh, I went to... Why, there's a friend of mine that lives there.
What? A he or a she friend?
A man. Upon my honour, a man.
Methinks I see the little wanton god on thy brow, all gay and smiling. Ah, such a boner rover! Was this your man friend too? To be lying in her arms, this fresco all perfumed air about me?
Well, well, madam. You will see that there are ladies in this world that will not be cruel. There are, madam, there are.
And there'll be men too, as fine, wild, inconstant fellows as yourself. There be, Captain, there be.
Therefore, I am resolved to see your face no more till tomorrow.
Oh, it can't thou frighten me.
Nor then neither, lest you swear never to see that lady more.
See her? Oh, why, never to think of womankind again?
Kneel and swear.
Oh, so I do. Never to see, nor lie, nor love with any but thyself.
Kiss the book.
Oh, most religiously. 'Twill be an age till tomorrow. Until then, I will most impatiently expect you. Adieu, my dear, pretty angel.
Now what a wicked creature am I, to damn a proper fellow.
Come, sister, we must stay no longer. It's getting dark.
I'll leave this to you. For when I am gone, you may repent the opportunity. You list by your modesty.
Ah, Florinda's picture. Florinda's friends. Florinda! Oh, 'twas she herself. What a dull dog was I!
It comes of your modesty, a pox on your vow.
Wilmore, see here, blessed opportunity lost! Whose picture's this? 'Tis a fine wench!
It's the Colonel's mistress, sir!
Oh, I thought it had been another prize! Ah, come, have another bottle, we'll set thee right again.
I am confident to try, and by that time it will be late enough our design in Florinda's garden.
Agreed!
Love does all day the soul's great empire keep. But wine at night pulls the soft gods to sleep.
Haste, haste! You'll be here straight.
Go I not gorgeous thus?
Now you look finely.
I would. I were as rich and as fine a lady as now I seem to be. Pray, Sancho, let me bear myself gently with my Englishman a little ere we see him.
Fie! How thou dreams, Lucetta! Not those shoulders as lace as mine with galley lashes! Oh, wear not your dress so low, lest he spy them.
Nay! 'Tis good to go thus when 'tis carnival.
Well, thou shalt bear yourself gently enough to make him hot. But not so hot that he undoes you. I'll thump you if you lick him.
Nay, fear me not.
Yoo-hoo!
Here he comes!
Lady, sweet soul, I must beg your pardon for coming this late.
Oh, I dare not say how much your absence has afflicted me. But rather, what joy your presence brings these eyes that love and adore her friend.
You... Boxalt! I put such kind things to say to her, such as lovers would use. And Artskins, what a fool was I not to learn a friend a little by heart before I came.
You are sad, sir. All's well. My old, jealous husband has gone hence. So fear you not, but come nearer. Do you love me? Nay, say you do, for I am so delicate a lady that I am ashamed to say how my heart aches for thee. Faith, thy sweet face and shape has made me your absolute captive.
Kind heart, how prettily she talked. Egad, I'll show her husband a Spanish trick. I'll throw her out of this world and marry her. She's madly in love with me. Why dost weep? No tears. What should smile on love?
Come, let's retire. 'Tis late and love would roost.
Will you be gentle?
Aye. I'll but sip thee as cat lick cream. Get an Artskins. I ache for thee.
Ah, sir, you speak my pains also. And my love and desires exceed your wishes, though I blush to say so.
'Tis well we are both hot.
But let's to bed and essay who is the hotter. I'll go in and undress me and be with you instantly.
'Tis a rare girl. One night's enjoyment with her will make up for all the days that I've passed in Essex. Sure, her embraces will make me far excel any pleasures I ever tasted. For I ne'er loved, nor was be loved till now. This is love's holy day, the restful working days in which I but ploughed these sets. Every look or touch burns or inflames my blood. 'Tis a pleasure to be sung thus. I'll bring her home with me to England. Lucetta, sweetest, I'm ready. Darling.
Are you not undressed yet?
As much as my impatience will permit me.
Hold, sir. Without the light, it may betray us else.
Anything, for I need no other light but that of thine eyes. And ask it, sir, I think I had it! Where are you, sweetest?
Meow.
Hoo, hoo.
Meow.
Pretty love trick this!
Now, sir, had any coy, we admitted this booty.
Oh, let's see what we have by this. Huh. A rich coat. These breeches, too, are well lined.
See here, a gold watch.
A purse. Gold! At least 200 pistols.
A bunch of diamond rings, one with the family arms. A gold box with the medal of his king and his lady mother's picture.
Ah, see, a bracelet of bowed gold. That's our security. He is not a stranger to us, but this country too. The common sewer into which he descended conducted me into another street. He knows neither your name, nor that of the street where your house is. Nay, nor the way back to his own lodgings.
Art thou not an unmerciful rogue, not to allow him one night of pleasure for all this?
Blame me not, Lucetta, to give as much as thee as I can to myself. Oh, come, that thought excites me and makes me wanton. Lest the bed, I'll lock up these. This is the fleece which fools do bear, designed for witty men to share.
This gold will buy us things. But what shall I do next tomorrow? Alas, I curse my future that has made me a slave to Sancho since I was sold. Would I had coin enough to fly to England and try my fortune. But what base measly girl the galleys must submit to, ere we can gain our ends. A common whore, oh fie! One that must yield to all the beastly embraces, yea, the nasty devices that men's lust can invent. And not only obey, but blow fire to, and hazard all diseases when their lust commands. And so sometimes we are enjoyed aforetimes, never after. Yeah, I cannot but laugh at this English fool. If I cannot rise in such a bad world, it is some recompense to bring such a fellow down. Lo, but is this bull calf not as naked as I once was on the shipboard? Oh, now I pity him. There's for thee, poor Essex calf.
Lucetta!
I come.
Dogs! Rogues! Pimp! Villains! Help! Help! Oh, good Lord. I've got it out at last.
Oh, Cotskoo!
To fancy she could be enamored with my person. Oh, dog. Oh, dull, silly, English country-believing dog! Alas, I know not where I am, nor how to get home. Hark!
These rogues and maskers must not see me thus, for I fear if we see violence to my sorrow,
we'll be summoned to vice here on the morrow. And yet I know there are many here of mine, who in my place would be likewise stung. And though you are better art to hide thy follies.
And Askins! You're all as errant callies!
Now am I on my way to happiness? Oh, and how I ache for Belleville! I've got myself free from Callis. My brother thinks not of me. Oh, and I have by good fortune got the key to the garden back door, which I have unlocked to prevent Belleville's knocking. A little noise will now alarm my brother. Oh, as fearful as a young thief, but as joyful as... Oh. Hark! Oh, what noise is that? What is he?
What the devil has become of these fellows, Belleville and Frederick? They promised to stay for me at the next corner. And now whereabouts am I? They're gone! Oh, very convenient place to sleep in. Oh. What has God sent us here? A female! By this very light, a woman. Oh, I'm a dog if it not be a very wench.
Who's there?
Sweet soul, let me salute thy shoestring.
Oh. It's not my Belleville. Who are you and from whence come you?
Oh, 'tis a delicate shining wench. Come, come, thou mayst be free with me. I'll be very secret.
Oh, heavens, what filthy beast is this?
Oh, I am so. And thou oughtest the sooner to lie with me for that reason.
Wicked man, unhand me!
Wicked? Come, come, you lie, you baggage, you lie. Why? At this time of night was your cobweb door set open, dear spider, but to catch flies. Come, I'm for ye.
Villain! Let go of that lady!
Help him!
Will more?
My mother has awakened. It will be impossible to escape. Hide under my chamber window. This rude man has undone us.
I'm a trade. Run, Callant, and see if Flemington be safe. Gone, so whoever they be, all is not well. I'll see Flemington's chamber.
You need not, sir. Your sister is fast asleep, and think no harm.
I would not awake her, sir, for fear of scaring her with your danger.
Rascals! How came the garden door open?
Some of my fellow servants masquerading, I warrant.
Masquerading? Lewd custom to the butcher youth. Yet I fear there is something more in this than I imagined.
Must you be a beast? A brute? A senseless swine?
Why, how the devil should I know twas Florinda?
Well, how the devil came you so drunk?
Why, how the devil came you so sober?
Death! I have no patience. Draw, or I'll kill thee.
Oh, let that alone till tomorrow. And if I not set all right again, use your pleasure.
Ah, damn it! Tomorrow, Florinda will be betrothed to Antonio. What I could meet with my happy rival. I'll plant myself under Florinda's window, and if I find no comfort there, I'll die!
Why, this is Angelica's house. I promised the kind baggage I'd lie with her tonight.
Here's Antonio, the Viceroy's son.
Hast thou received 1,000 crowns I sent?
Yeah, it is with the woman Moretta within. You're welcome, sir.
Who the devil have we here?
Don Antonio.
Yay, and I come to claim the prize I paid for.
What's this? A picaroon going to board my frigate? Well, here's one chase gun for you.
The mad Englishman has set upon my lord again.
Ring the alarm bell.
Belleville, see? The mad rogue's engaged in some unlucky adventure again.
Ah, oh, pox on him.
Help, a man killed.
Ah, killed? Well, then I'll go home to sleep.
Killed? Who should this be? Pray say the rogue is safe for all my quarrels, do
you? I'm wounded. Secure the villain.
Hands off. Do not mistake my charity for full villainy. I came to his assistance.
This Englishman has set up me twice.
Not I. Ugh.
Take him to my chamber until you have further order from me.
Has my humanity made me a criminal?
See well to the villain here.
Ugh.
St. Iago, swords drawn in carnival time.
I am cursed. I see fortune is resolved never to smile upon me. And here I am a prisoner. Yet it's nothing to torture my soul when I think of losing my fair, my dear Florinda. Alight, my captor comes. Now shall I die like a dull dog without defense?
Sir, tell me what injuries I have done to you, Englishman, to provoke such a mean action as to attack me basely without allowing time for my defense. It is the Viceroy's son whom you have wounded.
The Viceroy's son? Death and confusion. Don Antonio, my very rival. The man in all the world I wish to destroy. Sir, for a man in my circumstance to plead innocent would look like fear. But view me well and you will find no marks of coward on me. Me, anything that betrays that brutality you accuse me with.
In vain, sir. It is not you who drew me tonight. But yesterday, at the same house, that of Angelica.
If you want to kill me, I cannot fear you'll do it basely.
No, sir. I'll leave your defense with this.
This gallantry surprises me. What can this mean?
I have a quarrel with a rival, sir, about a young lady.
Death! 'Tis Florinda he means.
My rival challenged me to meet me on the molo tomorrow as soon as day appears. But my quarrel tonight has made my arm unfit to guide a sword.
I understand you, sir. You'd have me kill the man that lays a claim on the maid you speak of. I'll do it. I'll fly to do it.
I'll rob you of glory. For you must fight under my name and dress.
Agreed.
Come, sir. The day appears and calls you forth. Put on this habit.
Fantastic fortune, thou deceitful light, that cheats the weary traveller by night. Though on precipice each step you tread, I am resolved to follow where you lead.
I'm dying with my fears. Belleville's not coming to my window last night as I bade him. He makes me believe that all my fears are true.
Callis, tell me with whom my brother is to fight.
I do not know. I was by when they challenged one another yesterday, but they were both in masquerade. But I'm sure it is for you your brother fights.
They shortest with Belleville.
Madam, your brother's coming. If my master sees me, I shall be hanged for being your governor. I narrowly escaped last night for the excuse I made for you in the garden.
Go, unreward thee.
Where is Antonio? This place will soon fill and our duel may be prevented.
Antonio? Sure I heard amiss.
This must be he.
Antonio! Good morrow.
Oh, 'tis not my Belleville. Half my fears are vanished.
You are early, sir. I do not use to be outdone this way.
Come, sir, you know our times.
I am ready, sir.
Hold! Who will you be? If you strike here, I'll die.
Oh, wait, this kindness is unseasonable.
Oh, most dear, by her you love, I beseech you, touch him not.
By her I love. See, I obey, and here resign the useless trophy of my victory.
Antonio, you've redeemed my friendship and my sister.
Don Pedro.
Antonio, you resign your claims to Angelica. Give your heart eternally to Florinda.
Entire. This minute, let me make her mine. I can delay my happiness no longer.
This minute, let it be. No time so proper. Tonight my father arrives from Rome, and possibly may hinder what we purpose.
Oh, heavens, this minute, I'm quite undone.
But you may not be observed. Do you walk off to St. Peter's Church? I'll fetch a priest and meet you there, where we can conclude your happiness.
I'll meet you there.
I'm sure this is Antonio. Stay, sir, for I've not prepared my heart for such a stranger guest.
Do not know me. Move this way a little. She is coy. Best I speak to her in private.
I'll be with you straight.
Sir, you may force me to the altar, but you may never force me to be thine.
Oh, do not lose such a blessed opportunity. See, 'tis your Belleville, not Antonio.
Oh, Belleville! How long have I waited for this happy minute?
Ah, Belleville! Good morrow, noble colonel.
Belleville!
Death and confusion seize thee.
I beg your pardon, sir.
Nay, part us not. The lady is mine by conquest. I won her by my sword.
Faith, it is now so. Then child egad will keep her by the sword.
Stand off. Thou so profanely lewd, so cursed by heaven, all quarrels thou espouses must be fatal.
Nay, and you be so hot, my valour's coy.
Sir, you know I ought to claim the victor's right. But you're the brother to divine Florinda. I dares not hurt the man she holds so dear.
I am amazed. 'Twas by Antonio, not Belleville's sword, this question was to be decided, sir. But this mistake another time shall clear. This was a plot between you and Belleville, which I will prevent you. Sister, come away!
Do not be modest now and lose the woman. I'll fetch her back so.
Do not speak to me.
I know I've done some mischief. But I'm so dull a puppy that I'm the son of a whore, if I know how or where.
Leave me, I say, and leave me instantly.
I will not leave you in this humour, nor till I know my crime.
Death, I will tell you, sir.
Woo! Wilmore!
Sebastian, is that not Wilmore?
Hey, Stephen, bring him back.
The colonel's mad. I never saw him. Ah! Oh! I'll after him lest he do some mischief.
I'm all rage! My first love defeated, for one who has no other merit than Don Pedro's sister. Faithless, inhumane, barbarous man!
I told you what would come on't. Why did you give him 500 crowns? You should have kept him poor if you meant any good from him.
Name not such worthless trifles. They mean nothing! I gave him my heart!
My virgin heart, Moretta. What has gone?
Curse on him. Ah, here he comes.
How now? Turn shadow. Fly when I pursue and follow when I fly.
False man, I see my ruin in thy face. Have you forgotten your vows to me so soon?
Faith, no. I was just coming to repeat them.
Well, sir, you may be all gay. All happiness, all joys pursue you still. And every hour gives you choice of new hearts and beauties. But no, false man, you have done me wrong.
A box of this whining. My business is to laugh and to love. I hate a sullen lover. And what though I rove a little now and then? I doubt not you'll do likewise.
Oh, insolent devil! That creature I saw you entertain on the piazza last night, tell me, 'twas her 200,000 crowns you courted, and not she.
200,000 crowns? Huh! Is my little gypsy worth 200,000 crowns? Oh, how I long to be with her.
box, I knew she was of quality. 200,000 crowns. How shall I get away? Madam, 'tis not convenient I stay with you. I have a friend that's dangerously sick.
Nay, you shall not go.
I miss my assignation with my gypsy.
Pray, good gentlewoman, is this not Angelica?
My too young, sir, it is.
My mad captain's with her too, for all his swearing. Oh, how this inconstant humour makes me love him. Well, something I'll do to vex him for this. Madam, you shall hardly pardon my intrusion when you shall know my business.
Prithee proceed.
Nay, you shall not go!
Pox on! She stays there out of spite.
I come from a lady, madam. Young, rich, nobly born. But she has the fate to be in love with a young English gentleman. Strangely, she loves him. At first sight, she loved him. For he, she said, had charms in every word.
Egad, I hope this lady concerns me.
'Tis my false man he means. Would he were gone? This prince shall raise his pride and ruin me.
With this addition to his other beauties, he won her unresisting tender heart. Today was the appointed time by both to consummate their bliss in holy wedlock. And while she languished for the expected bridegroom, she heard he'd paid his broken vows to you.
So, this must be some new rogue that's in love with me and sends this boy here to tell me so.
No, I shall burst with jealousy.
Do you know the man you speak of?
Yes, madam. He goes about in buff.
Oh, what you man is thus you bring my jealous passion back?
Why would you, sir, abuse my lady's faith?
And use me so inhumanely.
A maid so young, so innocent.
So the storm comes finally on.
Now thou art silent. Guilt has struck thee dumb.
Young sir, thy lady's name in house quickly. I'm impatient to be with her.
So now he's for another woman.
Her name, dear boy, her name. Do I not know that face? My little gypsy! And all my hopes of a new woman banished! Egad, child, if I do not fit thee for this, hang me. Madam, I found out the plot.
Oh, Lord, what does he say? Am I discovered now?
You see this young spark here?
He'll tell her who I am.
Who do you think this is?
Aye, he does know me. Nay, dear captain, I am undone if you discover me.
Nay, I will teach you to spoil the sport you would not make. This small ambassador, madam, comes not from a lady of quality, as he says, but from a very errant gypsy. The talkingest, pratingest, cantingest little animal that thou ever sawest.
Did you not promise to marry her then?
Oh, not I. By heaven. If ever I should be inclined to marry, it would be some kind young sinner. One that has generosity enough to give a favour handsomely to those that can ask it discreetly. One that has wit enough to manage an intrigue of love.
By heaven, there's no faith in anything this man says.
So now they'll both join to plague me. Would I be out of this?
Madam, Don Pedro and Don Antonio sue to see thee. Ha! Antonio and my brother, they will discover me. Therefore, I'll retire without a ceremony.
I shall see Antonio. Get my coach ready.
Thanks, madam.
This is very lucky. Madam, I must be gone and leave you to the enjoyment of my rival. Farewell. Till you are in a better humour. Now to find my little gypsy.
Well, with what haste he took his leave. He's gone. In the ague of my soul, the shivering fit returns. In vain I consulted all my charms. Thought my eyes could kindle lasting fires. I see now that all men prefer the younger mistress. Well, sir, since I'm not fit to be beloved, I shall seek my revenge on him that shamed me thus and made me a goal and slave at carnival.
We're happily escaped, but yet I tremble still. Our brother's angry.
To our business. I delivered your note to Belleville and told him of your resolution to make your escape today and to die rather than marry Antonio. I bade him seek our brother out and persuade him that all passed upon the molos but a carnival mirth.
Yet I'm afraid. Let our devices go awry.
Has my wit not served well till now? How now, Helena? Does it go ill with your affairs also?
I know not yet, nor know I well how I should handle my mad captain, for he is as hard to catch as a falcon with no tresses. I see I must devise some newer trick to plague him.
I fear our brother's coming this way. I'll venture into Belleville's lodging. My life and honour are at stake, and my necessity has no choice.
The wait is there.
There's a mirth no more.
Tis well we are friends again.
Colonel! Oh, Colonel, such news!
Prithee, what?
News that will make you laugh in spite of fortune.
What? Ned Blunt hath had some damn trick put upon him?
Cheated, sir. Rarely cheated of all but a harlot's draws. The unconscionable whore Lucetta turned him out before consummation, so that, traversing the streets at midnight, the watch found him stark naked and conducted him home. By heavens, tis such a sight. I used as durst as well be hanged as laughed at him or pity him. And he beat all that do but ask him a question is in such a humour.
Who was met with this ill usage, sir?
Oh, friend of ours, you must see for mirth's sake. Prithee, Fred, go you to my lodgings and keep him in that posture till we go. Let's go find Wilmore.
Tailor for not yet bringing me the clothes I bespoke. I fear I shall be discovered naked. Worst of all, the Colonel of Wilmore will abuse me out of all Christian patience. The rascals will not insult me for too long, for I resolve to arm myself thus. What a fool was I to believe woman, to be soothed into a cousining, a fine lady like whore to cheat me thus. A potlight of her. I shall never be reconciled to the sex more. What I would give to have one of them within my reach now, any mortal thing in petticoats whom to be revenged on. Oh, dog. Oh, dull, silly dog.
This house is haunted, sure. Man, how is it tired? Sir?
Ha! Are my wishes not granted? Is that not a she-creature? And asking's tis. What wretched thing art thou, ha? Huh?
Sir, I'm a very wretched maid, forced here by strange unlucky accident to seek a safety here, and must be ruined if you do not grant it.
Dost thou know into what den of mischief thou art fallen? Dost not see something in my looks that frightens thy guilty soul?
Alas, what mean you, sir? I beseech you, as you seem a gentleman, pity a harmless virgin that takes your house for sanctuary.
Harmless virgin with a pox. Come, no resistance. To the bed with them.
How dare you be so cruel?
Cruel? Yes. I will kiss thee and beat thee all over. Kiss thee and see thee all over. Thou shalt lie with me too. Not that I care for enjoyment, but let thee see I will be revenged on one whore for the sins of another. I will flatter thee, I beat thee, embrace thee and rob thee, and she did me, fall on thee, and strip thee, start making come! Come on!
What's here to do?
But ask it, Fred, I'm glad thou art come to be witness of my dire revenge.
What's this? Another person of quality who is upon the ramble to supply the defects of some brave, impotent husband?
No, this has another pretense. Some very fortunate accident brought her hither. To Fool's Haven, for both my enjoyments of pleasure and revenge. For I am resolved to make up my losses on thy body.
By all that's holy, believe me, I am a lady of quality.
Very like. Why go you thus tricked out, so wanted?
Why, for just carnival.
And ask his friend. We'll both lie with her, then leave me to bang her.
I will assist you in matters that have a double pleasure in it. No resisting your destiny, sweetheart. Come.
Oh, say, sir, I've seen you with Belleville, an English cavalier. For his sake, use me kindly.
Belleville?
Belleville? But Askins, I wish he were here now. He's a caborage at whore and bacon. He'd add a limb or two of thee on my virgin palate.
If you have any esteem for that Belleville, I conjure you to treat me with more gentleness. And if you think I merit better treatment than you threaten, pray take this ring.
Huh? A diamond?
A diamond? begin to suspect something. It would anger us vilely to be trussed up for rape upon a maid of quality, when we believe we only ruffle a harlot. Stay. This ring shall reprieve her till we see Belville.
That is hard, yet I will grant it.
Oh, Ned,
Lord! At last, it's about done. Fred, lock up the wench in your chamber.
Fear not, madam. Where he frets, you're safe in my hands.
Oh, woe, God's alive!
Laugh out your laugh, do you hear? Be gone! I shall spoil your sport house. I shall! Adamkins, pot upon my tailor!
How the whore has dressed him!
Sir, that I am a stranger to thee. I am ashamed by the rudeness of my nation. Would you learn who did this would insist in making an example of them?
Aye, here's one that speaks sense now. And I shall tell you now, gentlemen, I have revenge within my power. For in my possession I had a woman who attacked me here in my own chamber, and would have doubtless committed a rape upon me had this sword not defended me.
I know not that. But oh my conscience, thou had ravished her had she not redeemed herself with a ring. Let's see his blood.
Ha! The ring I gave Florinda when we exchanged our vows. Hark you, Blunt!
Come, where's the wench? The key, let's see this lady.
Aye, let's see her. I can soon discover if she be of quality or of your divisions. Sure, 'tis some common carrion. She never horn your house else. 'Tis a hot and crafty queen, so eager to it. I'll have her.
Oh, good heavens, defend me from discovery.
Come, fly me now. It's in vain to fly me.
Sure, she's undiscovered, yet how shall I bring her off?
Come, what bashful, be you kind as you meant when you entered here. She's so goodly limbered. I'll have her,
sir. Perhaps the lady will not be imposed upon.
Let her choose her man. Come, mistress, leave this pretend coyness and take your pick of five good fellows, so eager to the act thou camest for, as thou art apt to undergo it. Or if you will, take all five of us, and let me first the file!
Hold! Valeria!
My little gypsy!
Oh, sir, I have found you! The strangest accident, if I have breath to tell it!
Speak, where's Florinda? Helena's safe!
Aye, sir, she's safe, from any fears of you. Oh, what will she say?
Why, where's Florinda? Speak!
She's fled away in the habit of one of her pages, sir, but Callis thinks you may retrieve her yet. If you make haste away, sir, Callis will tell you the rest.
Dishonourable girl, she's undone my aims. Sir, you understand my necessity to leave you, and I hope you pardon it. I know my sister will make her way back fighting to you, and when she does, I expect her to be rendered back to me, for I will see her married to Don Antonio.
I shall consult my love and honour, sir.
Oh, my dear preserver, let me embrace thee.
What the devil is all this?
Mystery by this light.
I tell you, sister, thou hast chosen a very beastly cavalier to mail with, and this fellow is as brutish.
Come, make haste and get yourself married, for our brother will return again.
Oh, Florinda, I'm so surprised with fears and joy, so amazed to find you here safely. I can scarce persuade my heart into faith of what I see.
But hark ye, Colonel, is this not the mistress who has cost you so many sighs and me so many quarrels with you?
It is. Pray, give him the honour of your hand.
Oh, give me your pardon too.
A friend of Belleville may command me anything.
Death would I might. It's a surprise in beauty.
Boy, run and fetch your father instantly.
So now do I stand like a dog, and have not a syllable to plead my own cause by this hand, madam. I was never so thoroughly confound before, nor shall ever more dare look up with confidence till you are pleased to pardon me.
Sir, I'll be reconciled to you on one condition, that you follow your friend in marrying a maid that does not hate you, and whose fortune, I believe, is not unwelcome to you.
I had no inclinations that way. I should obey your kind commands.
And I should loathe to break my word with you, which was that if your friend and mine agreed, it should be a match between you and me.
Bear witness, Colonel. It is a bargain.
I, too, have a pardon to beg. Yet I find I'm so out of countenance that I'd be a dog if I would say anything to purpose.
Sir, I heartily forgive you all.
That's nobly said, sweet lady. Belleville, present her the ring again, for I find not the courage to look upon her.
Sir, I have brought to the father that you sent for. He will know your purposes and craves you speak to him, for I know not why you sent for him, whether it be for a christening or a burial.
Tis well. And now, my dear Florinda, let's fly and complete that joy we've so long wished and sighed for. Come, Fred, you follow?
Your example, sir. 'Twas ever my ambition in war, and must be so in love.
And must not I see the juggling knot tied?
No!
Thou shalt do us better service by being our god, lest Don Pedro's sudden return interrupt the ceremony.
Content, I'll secure the pass.
Sir, your tailor waits for you in your chamber with a noble suit all made to your measure. I warrant is a goodly.
Some comfort yet? I shall not dance naked at the wedding.
Sir, there's a lady without would speak to you. She's a very fine lady, and very eager to speak to you. I told her you were not at liberty.
Nay, bring her in. I dare not quit my post. This must be none but my little gypsy. Angelica!
Yes, traitor.
Ooh.
Does not my guilty blood run shivering through thy veins?
Hold, dear Virago, hold thy hand a little. I am not now at leisure to be killed. Death, I think she's in earnest.
What, sir, have you to say? Nay, don't speak. Tell me first how many such poor believing fools thou hast made to ruin. How many hearts thou hast undone.
Why, as I think of it, no more, no less than you.
You said you loved me.
So I did, in that instant.
And in that instant I gave you my heart. Why did you lie and cheapen me? Now I see you gave me no more than doglust, made me your spaniel bitch, and broke your vows to me.
Broke my vows? Where hast thou lived amongst the gods? For I have never heard of a mortal man who has not broken 1,000 vows.
Oh, impudence.
I wish I were that dull. That constant thing that thou wouldest have and nature never meant me. I must, like cheerful birds, sing in all groves, and perch a little while on every bough, billing the next kind she that flies to meet me. Yet, after all that, I could build my nest with thee. Did the repairing when I'd love my round, and still reserve a tributary flame.
Sir, you have a charm that almost persuades me to take you as you are and not as I will have you be. And yet, by God, I am one that would have all or none. Therefore, prepare.
Angelica!
Don Antonio, what the devil brought thee hither?
Love and curiosity. I saw your carriage at the door. Let me disarm you this unbecoming instrument of death. And who are you, sir? It's a very wretched man as to warrant a death from her.
One, sir, that would have made a better end to an amorous quarrel without you than with you.
Sure. It's the English rogue who took down her pitcher yesterday. Yea, the very same who set on me tonight. Blessed opportunity.
Antonio, hold! By all the passions you so lately vowed to me.
Oh, that's holy. I adore you so. Even my rival was charmed enough to make him fall victim to my jealousy. Shall live. And leave to love on still.
What's this I hear?
Antonio, yesterday I would not have sold my interest in his heart for by thy sword as won and lost in battle. And now to show my utmost of contempt, I give thee life, if thou wouldest preserve. Love when my eyes may never see thee no more. Live to undo someone else's heart who may prove so bravely constant to revenge my love. Sir, since I have 1,000 crowns of you, come to my chamber when you will. I care not.
Now I have her. Saint Jago, I am happy.
Antonio, stay! Have you forgotten Florinda?
Don Pedro!
What coward fear prevented thee from meeting me this morning on the mola?
Meet thee?
Yes, me. I was the man that dared thee.
Finding myself unapt to use a sword, I send another blade to do thee right.
'Twas Florinda's quarrel that we fought. And you, to show how little you esteem her, send me your rival Belle in your place. When I meet thee fit for the dispute, I will tell you my resentment.
I shall be ready, sir. Eerie long. To do you right.
If I could find Florinda now, why my anger's so high, I think I should give it to Belleville in revenge.
Faith, sir.
I believe the priest within has already been kind.
How? My sister married?
Oh, by this time I hope. And bedded too.
Dare he do this? Does he not fear my power?
Faith, no. Not at all. If you will go in and thank him for the favour he has done your sister, so. If not, I have a damned surly crew here who will keep you on board till the next tide and then clap you on board for prize. My ship lies but a league off the molo and we will show your dumb ship a damned English rover's trick.
Ah, the rogues of the new mischief. Wilmore!
Ah, Pedro. Colonel Belville, I hear you've married my sister.
You have no truth, then, sir.
Why so? Then I wish you joy, sir.
How?
By this embrace I do, and I am glad of it.
Are you in earnest?
By our long friendship and my obligation to thee I am. I love my sister, and will ever honour to make her happy. You are fitter for her than false Antonio. Now come, brother, lead me to my sister so she may now know I approve her choice.
Sir? Another lady's come.
Oh, my gypsy. Egad, child, I was e'er in despair of ever seeing thee again. My friends are all provided for within, each man his kind woman. And I was eve resolved to go abroad and confine myself to a lone cabin with nothing but the thoughts of thee.
Could you have left me behind?
Why, 'twould have broke my roving heart.
Sir, since your friends and mine are all provided for, will you be faithful friend to me now?
For being a friend, I cannot promise. For thou art of a form so excellent, a face and humour too good for cold, dull friendship. I am powerlessly afraid of being in love. Therefore, dear creature, let's retire to my cabin and fall to. Come, my bed is prepared for someone as clean and sweet as thy fair self. Let's retire and fall to.
Only if you'll agree to let the old gaffer Hyman and his priest say amen to it.
Hold! Hold! No bug words, child. Priest and Hyman, there'll be no vows here but love. Marriage is as certain a bane to love as lending money is to friendship. Come, give me thy hand. One kiss and I am thine.
One kiss? I am resolved you shall have none for asking such a sneaking sum. Farewell, Captain Single Kiss!
I see there is no way to conquer good nature but by yielding. I adore thy nature! And we'll marry thee. And we are so one of humour that it must be a bargain. Give me thy hands. And let the blind ones, love and fortune, do their worst.
Ha! Helena!
Ha! My brother! Now, Captain, show your love and courage. Stand to your arms and defend me bravely, or I am lost forever.
Hast thou deceived me too? Deceive thyself and heaven!
Be you but kind. Let me alone with heaven.
Belville, I did not expect this false play from you. All three ruined in an instant.
We three have consulted nature and reason, brother, and find that the right of claim that brothers have over sisters, or fathers have over daughters. And now, as in this carnival, we have enjoyed those advantages, that both strength and custom gives us men over our sex. It is both justice and wisdom to have done so likewise.
And I will give you to her. I may now be free from fear of her honour. Guard it now, if you can.
Faith, sir. I am of a nation that are of the opinion that a woman's honour is not worth guarding when she has mind to part with it.
Well said, Captain.
This was your plot, Valeria.
There's no altering destiny, sir.
Sooner than a woman's will? Then I forgive you all! And I hope you get my father's pardon as easily.
Tis very well, sir. I dare say you look so fine.
Well, sir, tis downly ill, sir. Good Lord, a Spanish habit!
What's the matter, Ned?
Pray, view me around and judge.
I must confess thou art kind of an odd figure.
Methinks I look like a bouquet garni stuffed full of fool's flesh.
Tis well. Methinks thou look even more cavalier. Come. Settle your face and salute your friends.
Whilst we'll to the good priest within. Have thou no trembling at the near approach?
No more than you have in an engagement or tempest.
Egad, thou art a brave girl, and I admire thy love and courage. But let us know no future dangers dread.
the present ventures of the marriage bed.